Hello friends, in previous class we discussed about the ray optics and auto instruments and wave optics. Let me start with the electric charges and fields, which is when a charge is attached. When charge is attached, what are the properties of the charges whenever it is attached? Called electrostatics. Statics means what it is doing in the state of motion. So what do you mean by the charge? We have two types of the charges, which is positive and negative. Is it negative? Remember, positive means loss of electrons. Loss of electrons is called positivity. And negative charges means gaining of electrons or excess of electrons. Excess of electrons or deficiency of electrons. Deficiency of electrons in your body is said to be positive, and negative means excess of electrons in your body is said to be negative. So what would be the properties of the charges? Each are vector on scale of charge is a scale of, and S unit is coulomb. Coulomb is a S unit, it is not a fundamental physical quantity, but it is a direct physical quantity. And then what happens? What is the important properties of the charge? How will the body be charged? By body can be charged by friction. By friction. Even it is in conduction. Charged body by conduction. Even the body can be charged by induction. Is it? Now friction means when a body is rubbed against each other, two insulators are rubbed against each other, one body will be positive charge and one body is negative charge. Conduction means same kind of charge is developed. On a negative body. Whereas induction means whenever we are taking a charged body, if it is a positive charged body, now when you have taken a conductor, what will happen? Then conductor, whatever it may be, then nearer to this positive charge body, negative charges are on the other end, positive charges are down. So what is the notion here? Like charges are down the other end, unlike charges is down the other end. Because of this one, what happens? The induction always precedes attraction. Attraction always precedes attraction. The positive name before it will be attracts. Is it? But here, friction repulses the shortest of the electric friction. Repulsion is shortest of the electric friction. Shortest. Look at this one. Induction always precedes attraction. We have taken a positive charge body. Even if you take a negative charge body, here positive and negative. So what will happen? The body is moved towards that charge body. If a positive charge body is placed near to a water stream of water flow, then what happens? The stream of water will be moved, attacked towards this positive charge object. That will be bent towards the charge object. Is it? And what are the characteristics of the properties of the charge? Charge is quantized. Quantized represents that all the charges are integral particles of the basic unit of charge, which is denoted by the E. E is the charge of the electron, which is 1.6 into 10 power minus 90 coulomb, where charge of the electron is negative, minus 1.6 into 10 power minus 90 coulomb. So that where n value is an integer, plus or minus, we take it as a plus or minus. Even charge is additive, all the charges can be added. And when charge is conservative, charge is a conservative nature of the charge, charge is remains conserved. Is it? Whereas charge is like charges repel each other and unlike charges attract each other. Is it? Remember that one. What is the important difference between the charge and mass? Mass is always positive. Always positive, but charge is maybe positive or negative. Now, if the charge is in motion, its magnitude does but mass can be, the magnitude of the mass can be affected by its motion. Is it okay? It affected by its motion according to the Einstein's theory of relativity. M is equal to m naught by root over 1 minus 6 square by 6 square. M naught is the mass of the body which is attached to motion. V is the speed of object. C is the speed of the light in vacuum. Whereas charge does not change with its motion. Charge does not change with its motion. This is one very important property. Now, if you are taking two identically charged bodies, here A and B, both are having same charges, same masses. Initially are having same masses, M1 and M. Now it is positive charge, it is negative charge. After charging, which will have no mass. Positive charge means what? Deficient of electrons. Negative charge means what? Excess of electrons. Therefore, mass of the B is greater than mass of the A, because more electrons are there, less electrons are there. Mass will be less. This is what the concept of the charge. Let me see what will happen if two charges are placed at a distance, or then what will be the force acting on the charge due to inertia, which is given by the Coulomb's law. According to the Coulomb inverse square law, the force of attraction between two charges is directly proportional to the product of the charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two charges. Now, combining this one, you can write S is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon r q1 q2 by r square, where this constant k is nothing but constant and depends upon the nature of the medium and system of units used. It depends on what? Nature of the medium between the charges and system of units used. Based on those two will be depends. Whereas if any other medium is taken, then for that one, in any medium, where epsilon is called permittivity of free space, for any other medium, F is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught k or epsilon naught q1 q2 by r square. Where k is called dielectric constant. Okay, now remember, if it is in vacuum, this is the force. If any other medium, what is this force? 1 by 4 pi epsilon k, that force will be reduces. Then F is equal to in any medium, F naught by k decreases, force will be decreases. Now we have two charges, and in between these two charges, here one medium is there and that constant is k to a distance r1. Here another medium is k2 of 4, that constant k2 1, which is k distance r q1 and q2. Then what would be the resulting effective distance? R is equal to r root k1 plus r2 root k2. Is it okay? Now, when you have taken two charges of different magnitudes, these two charges are having q1 and q2. Now, they are combined, they kept in contact for some time and again separated to the same distance q1 dash and q2 dash. Then what is the new charge? New charge will be shared, q1 is equal to q2 dash. That is equal to q1 plus q2 by 2. Charge will be equal in shape when they are in contact. After that, q1 dash and q2 dash, which is q1 plus q2 by 2, is the q1 plus q2 by 2 is the charge on a new charge on each body. Is it? But let me take, we have taken a two strings, two charges, and because of the equally charge, here positive charge, here also plus Q charge, here also plus Q charge. these two strings are before they get in contact. So what happened? Because of these charges, before charging, if they are separated by distance r. So what? Look at this one. This charge repels this one. This charge repels this one. Then force acting on second charge, and this is what first charge. Force acting on second charge due to first charge. Whereas force acting on first charge due to second charge repels. Yeah, 1, 2. But in these strings, tension forces are known, is it? What are tension forces here? If this is angle theta, if it is in angle theta, it is vertical. This is also theta. Then what is the component of the tension along this direction? T cos theta. And what is the tension along this direction? T sin theta. Is it okay? Similar as here also same. Now you can understand T cos theta is equal to weight of this charged body mg. T cos theta is equal to mg. T cos theta is equal to mg. Whereas T sin theta is equal to what again? T sin theta is equal to force due to force in between these two charges. Yeah. Then T sin theta by T cos theta is equal to what again here? F is equal to mg tan theta. Tan theta from this one you can write. Here it is r, it is x. Then this is what r by 2 x. Root of r square by 4 plus x square is the this distance between the two charges. Is it? Similarly, let us see when will be the force between these two charges maximum. If for maximum force, F maximum, what you take? Df by dx is equal to 0. Df by dx is equal to 0. Similarly, for system in equilibrium, system in equilibrium to be, here we have taken Q1 and Q2 charges are separated by distance x, and a charge for charge Q is placed at a midpoint. Then what would be the magnitude of this charge so that system in equilibrium? For equilibrium, net force on any charge is equal to 0. Now, on this charge, if you are taking force on first charge, remember, it is positive charge is over. Then we don't know what is this magnitude of charge. Then, F1, force acting between these two charges, FQQ plus FQQ is equal to 0. Net force must be 0. Then what is this force? K into Q square by what is this distance? Let us take x, r. Then this is what here x midpoint. This is what midpoint x by 2 r, it is x. X square plus k into Q by x by 2 whole square is equal to 0. Now k Q square by x square is equal to what? Minus k into Q by 4 by x square. KQ cancel. X square cancel. Then Q is equal to what? Minus Q by 4. And you should be able to charge minus Q. That is what system to be in equilibrium. So let us see what happens. When you have taken a positive charge, if you have taken a unit charge, it experiences some force on this charge. It experiences some force. And if it is a positive charge, it experiences force in outward direction. If it is a negative charge, it attracts this one inward. Therefore, the force acting on unit charge by the source charge is called electric field. Electric field. So what do you mean by the electric field? Force acting per unit charge, test charge, unit test charge. Which is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q by r square. Then electric field is inversely proportional to the square of the distance between the two charges. Sorry, square of the distance from where we need shattering. This is what r. Is it okay? Now what happens? F is equal to even. F is equal to r. This is one formula, q into e. charging to that S is equal to what is the charge? Unit charge. It is what? Source charge. Are you clear? Unit charge and source charge. Now, when we have taken a charge in an electric field, when charge at rest in electric field, in electric field, what happens? It follows a, here this is what electric field. Remember, for uniform electric field, all electric field lines are parallel to each other, parallel beam of light. Okay, where electric field lines are closer together, then the strength of the electric field is more. If the electric field lines are far apart, then the electric field strength is less. Is it? So that what we can understand here, when a charge at rest in the electric field, then we follow the straight line path. So here we have taken positive charge. If the positive charge is placed in the electric field, then the force acting on the charge is in the direction of the E. If it is a negative charge is placed in the electric field, then force acting is opposite to the direction of the electric field when it is at initially in the state of rest. But if it is having initial velocity, when it is having initial velocity, it follows a parabolic path. So let us say we have electric field and a charged particle is initially it is entering with certain velocity u, then follows what? Parabolic path. Or if it is placed in a electric field. But remember, force acting, whenever it is moving in electric field, force acting into the electric field, Q into E is equal to net force is what? Ma. Then what is the acceleration acting on the charged particle? A is equal to QE by M. Then what is velocity after some time? E is equal to U plus AT. If initial velocity is 0, then QE by M into T. Then what is kinetic energy? K is equal to half mv square. Then half into m into v is nothing but q square t square t square by m. M square is equal to q square t square t square by 2m. Is it? So this is what kinetic energy. Even distance travel is equal to what you know? Ut plus half at square. Initial velocity 0 means what you get time taken to travel that distance. T is equal to the one. 2s by a. And so this is all the motion of the charged particle in a uniform electric field or non-uniform electric field. But the directions are very important. For a positive charge, at any point the direction of the electric field is radially outward, away from that point. If it is a negative charge, the direction of the electric field at that point, at any point is towards that source charge. That is very, very important. You need to remember it. So we have taken two charges Q1 and Q2 which are separated by distance x. Then in between these two charges at what point, let us at what point is the resultant electric field is 0. If it is positive charge, the electric field due to this one is in this direction. It is a positive charge, the electric field due to this direction E2. Remember, only for unlike charges we get the electric field. For only for like charges we get the electric field neutral point. But for light charges, we will not get a field neutral point because for unlike charges means here positive means in this direction, if it is negative, that may be right here plus Q minus Q. What is the electric field at this point? Due to this one, positive charge means radially outward. Due to this charge, minus Q means the charge electric field is radially inward. Both are in the same case means the resultant electric field will not get 0. Therefore, only for light charges only. For light charges, we will get a neutral point. Neutral point means the resultant electric field, the point at which the resultant electric field is 0. Now, x, the distance of neutral point, if it is d, the distance of neutral point, x is equal to d by root over q2 by q1 plus 1. from Q1 charge. From Q1, if you take it is X. This is a point number, point P from Q1. Similarly, this is for in between charges. In between charges. But outside means so x equal to dy root over q2 by q1 minus 1. Minus 1. Outside charges. Even you take outside potential, this is two charges. Will not get. Let me take a positive. Even if you take this one. Due to the charge, what is the extra current field? Outward. Due to the charge, what is the extra current field? Outward. Will not get. Okay? For negative charges, you will get outward. That we need to understand. So, what is the neutral point? Now, for like charge, plus Q, minus, in between one get. But outward, we will get. Due to the charge, outward. Due to negative charge, inward. So, for like charges, inward, in between. For unlike charges, the neutral point is outside the two charges. That we need to remember. Plus one. Plus is outside, negative means, sorry, plus is in between charges, negative means outside of the two charges. Is it? And then, what would be the electric field? Electric field, electric dipole, a system of two equal and small charges, unlike charges, which are separated by a small distance is called electric dipole. Now, electric dipole moment, P is equal to Q into 2A, and remember, electric dipole moment is a vector, then what is the direction of the dipole moment from negative to positive charge, P cap. Now, what is the electric field to be a dipole on axillite and electric field to be dipole on equal on axillite from positive charge if you are taking E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P R by R square plus A square whole power 3 by 2. Is it? Whereas on equatorial line for short dipole means E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught 2 P by R cube. 2 P by R cube. So here R square minus A square whole square. Is it for short dipole is negligible? Then this one. On equatorial line E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught P by R cube, R P by R square plus A square whole power 3 by 2, For short dipole means 1 by 4 by epsilon naught, P by R cube. Is it? Now, axial line is equal to 2 times of the electric dipole on equatorial line. So, short dipole, that we need. What is the torque acting on a dipole? Torque acting on a dipole in electric field. Tau is equal to PE sin theta or P bar cross E bar. Tau is equal to. Is it? And when is it maximum? And when is it minimum? These things you can study. Now, what will be the electric field? Infinite long straight charged conductor. Charged wire or conductor due to this one, if it is a positive charge at a distance r, then what is the electric field at this point? Positive charge means what? Outward. Then E is equal to lambda by 2 pi epsilon naught r is electric field. Whereas if you are taking A, for what? Sheet. Charged sheet. The electric field, charged sheet means like this if you are taking positive charge at any point. Electric field is what? Sigma by 2 epsilon. Whatever be the point, electric field at that point is nothing but what? Sigma by 2 epsilon. For shell electric field, inside is 0. inside is 0, but outside is inversely same as the point charge. Outside same as the point charge. 1 by 4 by x naught q by r square it is charge. But whereas conducting sphere, non-conducting sphere, inside is directly proportional to r, whereas outside is inversely proportional to the r square. Then if you are drawn the graph to this one, 0 and r, at this point electric field, what happens when from center to this point, what happens? Electric field will be increases, but thereafter it will be decreases, inversely proportional to r square, and it is what? Directly proportional to r. So inside is directly, but shell means inside is 0. So what do you mean by the electric flux? Pi is equal to E bar dot A bar. Pi E, which is equal to E A cos theta. E A cos theta. Electric flux is equal to E A cos theta. Flux is magnitude. A is a vector, which is normal to the surface. Electric field is also a vector, which is always normally inward or outward for point charges. Is it positive or negative charges? Now, from Gauss law, which is Gauss law states that the electric flux for a closed surface is equal to the 1 by epsilon naught times of the net charge imposed by that surface. Net charge imposed by that surface. Then E into A is equal to Q by epsilon naught. Is it? Now let us see if you have taken two charges, then Q, Q, Q. So what is the electric field at this point due to this one? Outward, Q1, E1 let me take here. Due to this one, rate along this line charge and two charges, then E2, positive only, outward. It is also positive only, outward. E3, 1, 2, 3. Now how do we find resultant? You calculate resultant of E13. Both are perpendicular to each other. Then E square plus E square. Both are having same magnitude, which is 2 root E. But remember, what is the force between the electric field due to these two charges in between these two charges? We need to use vector concept. The electric field at any point due to the number of charges is the electric field due to the vector sum of the electric field due to the individual charges. So what do we get? At this point, what is the electric field? E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon q into q by what is the distance? If it is A, it is A, then what is this distance? Root 2A. Then 2A square, which is equal to E by 2. Then what is the resultant electric field? E13 is in this direction, E2 is also in this direction. Then E13 plus E2, which is equal to E by 2 plus 2 root E. Just will search those values and calculate. But remember, for a distributed mass, what is the electric field? So let us take a semicircular void, which is charged, of radius is R. And at this point, we have a dq charge, which is totally uniform charge, q is the charge. Then let us take dq charge of an angle d theta, which is at an angle pi r theta. So we need to find the at center due to this charge wire, semicircular ring, what is the electric field at this point. For that purpose, what is charge per unit length? Linear charge density, charge per unit length, charge per unit length is called lambda is equal to q by pi into r. But for dq charge, what is this length dl? Is okay? dl length, which is equal to r into d theta. This is what r into d theta. Are you clear? Then what is the charge per dl length? dl length, which is equal to q by pi r, charge per unit length into this length, r d theta. Is it? R cancel. Which is equal to what here? Q by pi d theta. Okay. Now look at this one. Due to this dq charge, at this point, what is the electric field? dE. If it is making an angle theta, if it is theta means this is also theta, then what is component of electric field in this direction? DE cos theta, but along this time what is the electric field? DE sin. Okay, but even if you have calculated along this direction, DE cos theta, DE sin theta, so along horizontal plane electric field will be cancelled, only along vertical direction electric field will be added. Therefore, electric field due to DQ charge, electric field due to DQ charge at center O, DE is equal to, DE is equal to what you get here? DE is equal to minus, sorry, DE is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught DQ by R square. DQ by R square, ready, sorry. Then DQ, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into DQ is nothing but what? Q by pi D theta, Q by pi D theta. DQ. Okay, charge per unit length DQ. 1 by 4 DQ by R square. Now let us see. Therefore, total electric field E along margin 0, DE cos theta, here also DE cos theta, equal to opposite direction cancel. Then DE sin theta is the resultant electric field integral. Limits are from where? 0 to pi. 0 to pi. Then DE value is to be here. 1 by 4 by epsilon naught Q by pi. Q by pi. And even R square is also constant. Is it? Integral sin theta D. 0 to pi. Then Q by 4 pi square epsilon naught r square into sin theta, what is formula? Minus cos theta. So minus cos theta, limits are from where? 0 to pi. It's equal to cos 90 minus cos 0. Then what do you get here? 2 q by 4 pi square epsilon naught r square into minus cos theta, which is nothing but 2 will get. 2 to cancel. That is equal to q by 2 pi square epsilon naught r square. Then what would be the direction? If it is I cap, if it is J cap, then what is the direction of the electric field? Vertical direction, which is minus J cap. That is equal to q by 2 pi square epsilon naught r square into minus J cap. Is the electric field due to the semicircular void on its at the center point O. So let us see, discuss the bits which we have. First one, let us see the first one. A body can be negatively charged by connecting it with a negatively charged conductor. So conductor means the same kind of charge will be applied. So it is correct only. Even, what is the next one? Rubbing, which is bisection also can be charged. By connecting with the air under the influence of positive charge conductor. Is it? Positive charge conductor under the influence. Look at this one. If it is a positive charge conductor, positive. We have a conductor. Is it? And what would happen then on this again? Near here we have negative charge. At this end what we have positive charge. But if it is given anything, what happens? This side, at this side is neutral, so only we have the picture. So all are correct for that. Second one, if an object of mass 1 kg contains 4 into 10 power 20 atoms. For 1 kg, number of atoms are how many? 4 into 10 power 20 atoms. If one electron is removed from every atom of this solid, the change gained by this solid is 1 gram. Now, that is for 1000 gram number of atoms are only 4 into 10 power 20 t, 4 into 10 power 20. Then, for 1 gram, how many number of atoms we have? Number of atoms in 1 gram. Number of atoms in 1 gram. N is equal to, what do you have? 1 into 4 into 10 power 20 by 1000. Which is equal to 4 into 10 power 20. 1000 equals numerator, what do you get here? 10 power minus 3. So 10 power 20 minus 10 power 17. 4 into 10 power 17 atoms we have for 1 gram. 4 into 10 power 17 atoms are there in 1 gram of this object. Now, 1 electron is removed from every atom. What is the charge gained by the body? Whenever the electron is removed, what happens? Deficiency of electrons takes place. Then what is the charge on the body? Positive. Therefore, when what are the number of atoms? Number of electrons removed. Number of electrons removed. No. How many number of electrons atoms are there? 4 in 10 power 7. For each will have one electron is removed. The number of electrons are how many? 4 into 10 power 17 electrons. Then charge from quantization of the charge. Q is equal to what? N into E. N is 4 into 17 into charge is 1.6 into 10 power minus 19. Then what you take? Q is equal to. So 4 into 1.6, 6.4 into 10 power minus 2. First half, is it? First half. A girl brings a positively charged zinc plate for positively charged rod near a thin neutral stream of water from tap. Is it? She observes that the water stream bends towards her. Instead, she brings a negative charge rod near to the stream. It will. What we have seen already? We have a tap. From this tap. So stream of water, neutral. Now we have taken it, she has taken it instead of positive charge body, negative charge body taken. Because of this, what will happen? Near to this negative charge body, here positive charge is induced on either end and negative charge is induced on the other end. Induction always receives attraction. Then what happens? This will be bends towards this one. Is it? So bend in the same direction. First case bends. Two identical size balls. Here we have positive charges Q1 and Q2, fourth one. So this is our one first option. And Q1 and Q2 respectively, but Q1 is not equal to Q2. Q1 is not equal to Q2. Identical size balls means M1 is equal to what? M2. Now the balls are brought together, so they touch each other and then kept in the original portions. The force between them, both are positive charges. What happens to force between them? What is force? We know F is equal to, or F is directly proportional to what? Q1, Q2. After touching, what is new charge? Q dash is equal to, Q1 dash is equal to, Q2 dash is equal to what? Q1 plus Q2. Right. The charge will be, what happens to charge induced? The equal shape. So what will happen? For example, these two are possible identical masses, M1 and M2. Remember, if these two are positive charges, if those two are positive means, what happens to new charge? For example, 6 microcoulomb, 2 microcoulomb, 6 into 12, 6 into 2, 12 micro. But here what you get? 6 plus 2 by 2, is it? 8 by 2, 4 microcoulomb, is it? But whole square, what happens? This F dash is directly proportional to Q1 dash into Q2 dash. What you get? 16, but you get 12. What happens? Increases if they are light charges. If they are light charges means increases. Okay, but unlike charges means what? If one is Q1 minus Q2, then what is the new charge here? Q1 minus Q2 by 2. So new, this will be what happens to this one? 6 minus 2 by 2. 6 minus 2 means what? 4. 4 by 2 means what? 2. 2 square means what? 4. Is it okay? Then in this case, what happens? Force will be decreases. So what options? What options will be? You can take fourth one. Increases. increases. For like charges means increase. For unlike charges means decrease. So in options they have given second option. But here they, in question they given and we have positive charge. So first option only is the correct. If it is unlike charges, second one is correct. Are you clear? Next, fifth one. Two positively charged spheres of masses M1 and M2 are suspended from a common point at the ceiling by an insulating massless strings of length L. And massless or strings of length L. Is it? Charges on the two spheres Q1 and Q2 respectively at equilibrium, both the strings makes the same as state of the vertical. Is it? At equilibrium. What happens? Same we have seen tension is T, UD is theta, then what is tension? Theta. Then what is this one? Mg here also what? Mg, M2g, M1g. Then F1, force between these two charges is remains the same. It remains also F. Is it? Here Q1, here Q2. Now force of the charge into this one, outward, repels. And force of the charge into this one, the charge repels, outward. Force on first charge into second one, force on second charge into first one, both are have same. Then remember, F21 is equal to M1g, tan. Force acting on second, M2 is tan. Even F12, force acting on second is M1g, tan theta. But remember, F21 and F12 are equal, same charges, but equal forces, but opposite in direction, only direction is opposite. Therefore, F12 is equal to R, F21, then M1 is equal to what you get? M2. Which is second option, the sixth one. Two particles and we have equal charges placed at a distance d apart. Two particles and with equal charges d apart. A third charged particle placed on the perpendicular bisector of AB at a distance x. At a distance x. Then equal charges. Let us take here Q and Q. And distance is what here? D apart. Distance is D apart. A third charged particle placed on the perpendicular bisector of AB. If you are taking A and B, AB, perpendicular bisector at a distance x. Now at D by 2. Here it is D by 2. At a distance x. A third charge particle is taken. The third charge particle experiences maximum force when? Is it? So, this charge, when does it experience maximum force? When does it experience maximum force? Is it? We need to find what is. Remember, what is force into this one? What is force into this charge if it is the same charge? Outward? Yes. Even due to the charge also, what is the direction of force? F. Is it? No, if it is theta, then what is the sign of theta? If it is this is also theta, what is the sign of theta? Remember, you resolve into these components also. Due to this one, what is F cos theta and along this direction, F sin theta. Similarly, due to this force component here, F cos theta, F cos theta and along this direction of force, F sin theta. Now, along horizontal direction of force will be what? Zero. Then along vertical direction, what is resultant force? 2F cos theta. Therefore, resultant force is equal to 2F cos theta. That is equal to 2 into F. What is F resultant? F is nothing but 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught q into q Q1 Q2 by R square. R is nothing but what? R square. Then 2 by 4 pi epsilon naught into R 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught into Q into Q. Q square by X. What is this one? X square plus D square by 4 whole square. X square plus D square by 4. Root over X square plus D square by 4. Again whole square. Whole square. Root 2 square will be cancelled. Is it okay? Then this is the resulting force. Into cos theta. What is cos theta? If it is theta, cos theta is nothing but adjacent by hypotenuse. Cos theta is nothing but what? X by R. R is nothing but what you know? R is root over X square plus D square by 4. Then X square plus D square by 4 whole power 1. Therefore, 1 by 2 pi epsilon naught Q square by 2 pi epsilon naught X by X square plus D square by 4 whole power 1. Here whole power 1 by 1 plus 1 by quantity here 3 by 2. Is it? Now you should get magnitude. When will you get magnitude force? For what distance of X will you get magnitude force? Then what do you get? For FR maximum, what should be the differentiation? DFR by DX equal to what? 0. Differentiate. Remember, this is QL is constant, 2 pi epsilon is also constant. Then you can write this outside Q square by 2 pi epsilon naught into D by DX of this value, U by V method. X square plus D square by 4 whole power 3 by 2 is equal to what? 0. Now look at this one. If you take into this side, it will become 0. But if you write it is differentiation, first x square plus D square by 4 whole power 3 by 2 into D by DX of X. We have kept this constant, differentiate this one. Minus next term. X is kept constant. Now we differentiate this one. D by DX of this one. D by DX of X square plus D square by 4 whole power 3 by 2 is equal to 0. Is it okay? Now write X square plus D square by 4 whole power 3 by 2 into 1 minus this one X into this one here. D by dx of x power n, n into x power n minus. Is it? Then 3 by 2 into x square plus d square by 4, 3 by 2 minus 1, which is nothing but 1 by 2 into again, we have to go for x square, 2x. Is it equal to what? Now, 2 cancel. You can take x square plus d square by 4, whole power 1 by 2 as common. Then what is remaining here? X square plus D square by 4, 1. Minus 3x, this is taken down already. 3 into x, 3x into x. 3x square is equal to what? 0. Then if this comes to this side, 0. What do you have? Or D square by 4 minus 2x square is equal to what? 0. Then 2x square is equal to what? D square by 4. Then root 2 x is equal to what? D by 2. Therefore, x is equal to what? D by 2 root 2. So, for this distance, for x value d by 2 root 2, that is on this charge, the resultant force will become 0. Is it? Let us see another one. The nucleus of helium atom contains two protons. Then Q1 is equal to Q2, which is charge of the proton is what? 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 90. And these two charges are separated by distance what? 3 into 10 to the power minus 15 meter. The magnitude of the electrostatic force that each proton enters the other. Here one proton, here another proton, which are separated by distance. Then F is equal to what is formula? 1 by 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 by R square. From what? Coulomb's inversion. plus beta. That is equal to 9 into 10 power 9 into Q1 E into E 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 by R square 3 into 10 power 15 whole square 3 into 10 power 15 whole square. That is equal to 9 into 1.6 into 1.6 2.56 into by 9 19, 10 power minus 9, 19, 9, 10 power minus 10, minus 10, minus 19, 10 power minus 20, 9, into 3 square means 9, 10 power 15 whole square means what? 10 power 30, 10 power 30, if it is most numerator, minus 30, is it? Sorry, this is 10 power minus 15, right? Minus 30. 9 9 cancel. Then 2.56 into minus 30 goes to numerator plus 30. Minus 29 plus 30. 1. Then 10. Which is 25.6 newton. Let us see. Next one. 8th one. So half is what? First one. 2 point charges are 3 meter apart. Then separation between 2 charges is 3 meter. 3 meter. And the combined charge is 8 microcoulomb. Combined charge is for U1 plus U2 is equal to 8 microcoulomb. The magnitude of the electrostatic force the force of repulsion between them is 0.012 newton. Force of repulsion F is equal to 0.012 newton. Then what are the magnitudes of the charges? What are the charges? Let us see. Look at this one. Q1 plus Q2 is equal to 8 newton, 8 microcoulomb. Then Q2 is equal, let us say, 8 minus Q1 microcoulomb. Is it? Now, F is equal to, we know that, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q1 Q2 by R. Circuit 0.012 is equal to 9 into 10 power 9. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught is what? 9 into 10 power 9. Into Q1 into Q2. Q1 is what? Q1 into 8 minus Q1 into microcoulomb. Micro means 10 power minus 6. Here 10 power minus 6. Here 10 power minus 12. You are 10 power minus 12 by R square. What is R value? 3 meter. 3 square. So 9 is 3 square cancel. What is R remaining? Q1 into 8. So let me write here. 8 Q1 minus Q1 square is equal to 0.012 by, look at this, 10 power 9 into 10 power minus 12, 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 3, is it? By 10 power minus 3. So by 10 power minus 3 means what are you getting here? Into 10 power 3, into 10 power 3, which is equal to 12. Is it? Then 8 Q1 square minus 8 Q1 plus 12 is equal to 0. So Q1 square 12 means 2, 6, 12. Let me write here. 2 Q1 minus 6 Q1 plus 12 is equal to 0. Then Q1 if we take common, Q1 minus 2 minus 6 into Q1 minus 2 is equal to 0. Therefore, Q1 is equal to what? Q1 is equal to 2 comma 6. It okay? Then if Q1 is equal to, Q2 is equal to 6. If Q1 is equal to 6, Q2 is equal to 2. Then 2 microcoulomb and 6 microcoulomb are the answers. Which are? First half, 6 microcoulomb comma 2 microcoulomb. A charged particle is free to move in an electric field. It will travel always along the line of force. Is it true? No. Only when it is at rest position, then it can travel along the line of force. But along a line of force, if its initial velocity is 0, yes, second option is correct one. Along a line of force, if it has some initial velocity, no. If it has initial velocity, then it follows a parabolic path. So second option is correct. Let us see. 10th one. 10th one. A thin conducting ring of radius R is given. R
R is given at O ring. Ring. O. Here it is K, A, P, C, D. This is what given. The electric field at the center O of the ring due to the charge on the part A, K, B. This one. A, K, B is what? Electric field is what? E. So due to this one, tell me. Due to this, what is the direction of the electric field? So along K. Due to A, K, B. Let O, E, along K, O. Direction is along K, O. But they are asking to find ACD. Due to ACD, what is the electric field at this point? Remember, resultant electric field at this point due to ring at its center is 0. Is it okay? So then, what do we get here? At this point, look at this one. If it is charged Q by 4, Q by 4, Q by 4, Q by 4. Equal charge only. Now, due to the charge, BC and AD. Due to this AD, what is the direction of electric field? In this direction. Due to this one also, the direction of electric field is in this direction. Are you okay? Then, the direction of the electric field due to this one, magnitude is in this direction. E, A, C, D, B. Same magnitude, but what is the direction here? Opposite in direction. Along K. E only, but along O, opposite in the direction of the electric field. So, which is first option? Let us see. 11. Two charges Q1 minus 3Q are placed at some distance apart. If the electric field at the location of Q is E, then at the locality of minus 3Q, it is. There minus Q and 3Q. Minus Q and 3Q. Which are separated at some distance. Let us take any distance. Is it? The given electric field at location of Q is E. At location Q, how do you get electric field? Due to the charge at this point 0. But due to the charge, you get electric field. Now, due to the charge, what is the direction of electric field? E. Okay. At minus Q, electric field is due to 3Q will get. Then E is equal to what? 1 by 4 by epsilon naught 3q by r. But at location of 3q, at location of 3q, due to minus q, electric field E dash. Are you clear? At this point, due to 3q is 0. But due to which part will get a charge electric field? Due to minus q charge at this point will get electric field. Then what we can get here? E dash is equal to 1 by 4 by epsilon naught q by magnitude we have taken. By what is the r square? Remember, at this point, due to this charge, what is the direction of electric field? Towards the source charge, negative charge field. But here it is positive charge, so that it is outward. That means E when E dash drops in the direction of the E. Are you clear? Then 1 by 4 pi epsilon q by r square, which is nothing but what again, right? E by 3. That is equal to E by 3 in the same direction. E dash is equal to what? E by 3, which is first option. Let us see, 12th one. Here we have the three infinitely long charge series minus q, and this is what x axis, the origin. Here z is equal to minus a, z is equal to a, and surface charge density is minus 2 sigma. What do you mean by surface charge density? Charge per unit area. And third one is z is equal to 3a, at a distance 3a on z axis, sigma. The electric field at point P.
Here we have a point P. Is okay? Now, let me take here 1, 2, 3. Tell me, what is electric field in a sheet?
Electric field due to sheet at any distance.
It does not depend upon distance. E is equal to what? Sigma by epsilon.
Is it? Now tell me, due to first one, at this point, it is negative charge.
Then what is the direction of electric field?
E1. Similarly, this is negative charge. What is due to this one?
E2.
Okay?
Radiate towards the sheet. Towards the sheet.
But remember, carbon is positive. At this point, due to positive charge means outward.
Means it is also in the same direction. Therefore, resulting electric field at P. Resultant electric field at P, E is equal to what again? E1 plus E2 plus E3. Then E1, do this one, minus sigma by 2 epsilon r plus, sorry, sigma by 2 epsilon r plus magnitude solar time. E2, E2 is also what? Sigma, but surface charge is here 2 sigma by 2 epsilon r plus E3, do this one, sigma by 2 epsilon r. Then 4 sigma by 2 epsilon r, which is nothing but 2 sigma by epsilon r.
Tell me, what is the direction of the resulting?
In the direction of negative z axis, then minus k cap. Minus k cap, first. Let us see that in first.
Two charges plus or minus 20 microcoulomb.
Here plus minus 20 microcoulomb and here B is at A point plus 20 microcoulomb and a point P. Point P at this point electric field. Remember plus 20 microcoulomb. So this is what 10 millimeter apart. From midpoint, this point is at the 10 centimeter distance. R is equal to 10 centimeter distance. Is it? Now dipole length is what 10 millimeter, which is 10 millimeter means 10 into 10 power minus 3, 10 power minus 2 meter. R is equal to what is R? 10 centimeter, which is 10 power minus 1 meter. You need to find electric field at point P on the axis of the dipole, away from the center of the dipole.
Remember, this is nothing but dipole. What is electric field to the dipole on axial end?
Electric field to the dipole. Dipole. On axial line, E is equal to 1 by 4 by epsilon naught, what? 2p by rq. 2p by rq for dipole. Then 1 by 4 by epsilon naught, q into 2a by rq. 9 into 10 power 9 into q, what is p value? 20 into 10 power minus 6. Into 2a, 2a value is nothing but what? 10 power minus 2 by r cube, 10 power minus 1, 4. Is it? So 9 into 22, 18 into 10 power, here 10 power minus 2, 10 power minus 6, 10 power minus 8, 10 power 9 into 10 power 10. 10 power 10 power not 10, 10 power 10 minus 8, 10 power 2, 2, yes, 10 power minus 2 goes to 10 plus 3, 10 power plus 3, then 18 into 10 power 5 newton per coulomb.
Where we have gone from 2p, yes, ये 2 into q, the dipole moment, then 2 into, then here what 2 into, 36 into 10 power 5 newton per coulomb. Or even you can write 3.6 into 10 power 6 newton per coulomb, so which is 4th option.
14th one, so that is what we have seen already, minus q by 2 pi square epsilon r square j cap, third of already we discussed in concepts only. Let us see 15th one. 15th one, a pendulum of mass m carrying charge q at rest with its string making length theta with the vertical in a uniform electric field E. Here we have a string of charge q, now it is in the electric field. So due to this electric field, what happens? Force will be acting in the direction of electric field. Now because of this force, it is making an angle theta. It is twisted by an angle. The tension in the string reaction. So resolve the components here, theta means what is this one? T cos theta, which is m. Whereas what is this one? T sin theta is equal to what? Q. Therefore, T cos theta is equal to mg, then T is equal to what? Mg by cos theta. Or even T sin theta is equal to what again? Force due to electric field, QE. Then tension is equal to what? QE by sin theta. QE by sin theta. So that is what first option is it? First option. 16th one. So here in 16th one, in the following hours situation, four situations, charge particles are at equal distance from the origin. Arrange them with the magnitude of the magnetic field at origin greatest cost. So greatest to the least, lowest. At this point, at same distance, then same charge. Now what is the electric field due to this one? Electric field due to E is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught n into q by r square. Same charge, same magnitude, then what again? N into E, let me take like that. So that it is instant. Now due to this one, what is the electric field at this point outward? Phi E. And due to the charge, what is the electric field? 2E. But even this minus E is also due to this four charge. At this point, in what? What's the source here? 3. Now what is total electric field here? 5e and 5. Here 5e, here 5. Both are perpendicular to each other. Then E is equal to what you know whatever? E1 square plus E2 square plus 2E1E2 cos theta. And then theta 90, 0. So that is equal to what you have to do? 5 root 2 E. Is it 5 into E? 5 into E, E1 is equal to 5. In this case, due to negative charge towards the source charge, due to this negative charge, 3E towards this charge, 2Q, positive charge, 3E, sorry, 2E. Then what is total electric field along this direction? 3E. Along this direction is what? 3E. Then what is electric field in this case? 3 root 2E. E2 is equal. Now look at this one. At this point, positive charge. At this point, positive charge is radially outward, 2E. But negative charge, due to the charge at this point, negative charge is towards the negative charge, 3. Then here it is what? 5. E3 is equal to what? 5. And here, due to negative charge, E. And due to 2Q, what is charge? What is electric field? Radially, same charge, 2E. Is it? Here no, the charge not there, here. Only 3Q and minus Q, 3Q. 3Q and minus Q. So what is here? 3E and even 2E in this energy, 5E. Minus 3Q
first one, second one. तो आपन 4q minus 2q. 4q minus 2q. Now 4q means here 4e, 2e, 6e, 8e. Fourth one 3q minus 2. 3q minus 2. 4e. So these are what 6e, 4e, 3 root 2e, and here it is what 5 root 2e. Greatest first. Greatest means what we have here? Greatest means what we have here? See that greatest means what we have here? This one is 5 into 1.414. Next what again? 6. Next 3 into 1.414. This one. Then 1, 3, 2, 4. 1, 3, 2, 4. Which is what option we have? Fourth option. Is it? So these are what some we have discussed. Let me write equations due to some different objects. So this is what I am going to be giving. At a distance x from the center of the ring, 1 by 4 by x not 2x by r square plus root over 3 by 2. Whereas for this, at a distance x from its center, sigma by 2 x not 2 1 by x square power s square plus r square. At x is equal to 0, means x square is equal to what again here? This term will become 0, then e is equal to what? Sigma by 2 x not. Is it okay? So let us discuss the remaining concept and bits in next class. Thank you.